Spaz here with your Green Brief update. Green Brief number 24, July 10th of 2009. There was a gathering of the families of those detained during the protests in Tehran today. Numbers cannot be confirmed, but the numbers were probably very small. It has not been confirmed that Basij attacked the dorms of the Polytechnic University on the 9th. The presence of Rafsanjani's family was partially confirmed, and still no word of whether Mousavi joined mourners later in the evening like he said he would. The Guardian Council said that they were currently going over the entire election. The council will soon release a detailed report about the election. The French ambassador in Tehran met with a detained Frenchwoman who is currently being held in Iran on charges of espionage. According to the ambassador, the detained woman looked in good mental health. It is not clear as of yet when she will be released. Iran's government today summoned the German ambassador and questioned him on the death of an Egyptian woman in Germany. Iranian TV continues to show her death and accuse the West of acting against Muslims in Europe. The G7 nations and Russia have given Iran until September to restart negotiations on its controversial nuclear program. It was unclear what Iran's rejection of this offer would entail. The statement came during a meeting in Italy where the group was meeting to go over the worldwide economic downturn. A U.S. panel has demanded that Baha'is facing trial in Iran be released immediately. Baha'is are a religious minority in Iran who believe in a universal religion and are passionate supporters of world peace. They are openly persecuted because of the country's strict religious laws. The Canadians also summoned the Iranian ambassador in Ottawa and demanded the immediate release of a Canadian-Iranian journalist. She has been detained for a while now, and the government is trying to keep a lid on her whereabouts. She works for Newsweek. Fars News has reported that the government has discovered a recording studio belonging to the BBC at Mousavi's campaign headquarters. Iranian media continues to beat the drum on an Egyptian woman's death in Germany, and protests yesterday were for the most part ignored. This has been a Green Brief update. Thank you.